5 months ago, my boyfriend broke up with me, and I was originally going to ask, how do I get over my ex? And then I thought some more. I asked myself, why am I not over him? And then I thought, because I'm way too attached. Because maybe I don't want to get over this guy because of all the past memories and then hope for more. Well, he knows that I still like him. And he knows, he told me that he doesn't like me. But I just felt really pathetic. And we still maintain like a close relationship even now. So thus, I tried getting over him in many ways. And I tried surrounding myself with lots of things, including my friends and other guys. And that obviously didn't work. So I thought to myself, wow, I seriously do depend on other people. So like now I want to ask you, how do I get less attached? And I know you said before that this is a habit, and I'm pretty young. So how do I break that habit? And how do I become independent, as in what I do? And like as in realize I don't need a guy in my life for my needs and happiness.
Let's
say this is a piece of gold.
이것을 내가 금은 필요 없는 거야라고 지금부터 생각을 합니다.
So I'm going to start telling myself that I don't need this piece of gold.
금은 돌일 뿐이야.
I say this gold is just another rock.
그래서 어느 나무 밑에 묻었습니다.
So I bury that underneath some tree.
그리고 잊어버려야 돼.
And told myself I need to forget about this rock.
나는 거기 묻은 적이 없어.
I say I don't even remember burying this.
이렇게 잊으려고 10년을 애를 썼습니다.
So I tried to forget about this rock for 10 years.
10년이 지난 뒤에
And after 10 years.
어디 묻었는지 기억할 수 있을까요? 못할까요?
Do you think you'll still remember where you buried that rock?
If you keep thinking about it for 10 years then yeah, but if you don't then no.
아니, 10년 동안 잊어버리겠다고 노력했대.
Say you told
나는 그걸 묻지 않았어. 나는 몰라. 이렇게.
Say you kept yourself, you told yourself for the past 10 years that I need to forget about this rock. I need to forget about this rock. I don't remember where I buried that rock. After 10 years, you think you still remember where you buried that rock?
No.
정말?
Really?
Well, if you keep telling yourself, that means you're still remembering it. I don't know.
만약에 칼을 가지고 이걸 이렇게 딱 그어봤어요.
So I took a knife and I scratched it.
아, 이거 몇 개 한 거예요. 바깥에 치라.
Then I realized it's not actually real gold. It's just a covering.
안에는 보니까 그냥 쇠붙이뿐이었어요.
Inside was just a piece of worthless metal.
그래서 제가, 어, 그럼 아니네 이랬어요.
So I said, hey, this is not even gold.
그리고 어느 나무 밑에다 묻었어요.
And so you threw that away. You buried it underneath some tree.
어, 기억해야지.
Then you told yourself, I need to.
어느 나무 밑에 묻었어.
Which tree I buried this?
매일매일 기억하자.
And you tell yourself, I have to remember every single day.
그 10년이 지났어.
And after 10 years.
기억할 수 있을까요, 없을까요?
You think you still remember where you buried it?
No.
네. 왜 그럴까요?
Then why? Why not?
하나는 기억 안 하려고 했는데 기억이 저절로 되고 하나는 기억하려고 했는데 기억이 안 되잖아요.
So first example was that you know, you tried not to remember but you still remember. This one you tried to remember but you forget. Why is that?
그러니 기억하려고 기억을 잊으려고 노력하는 것은 굉장히 그러니까 이렇게 어리석은 사람이 하는 노력이에요. 일이에요.
So trying not to remember is actually a foolish effort.
그건 마치 꿈속에서 강도에게 쫓기는 사람이 도망다니는 것과 같은 거예요.
It's almost the same thing as trying to run away from a robber in your nightmare.
이게 금 아니구나 하고 알아버리는 게 중요한.
What's important is for you to realize and wake yourself up to the fact that this actually is not gold.
이게 사실을 안다는 거예요.
to actually see the truth.
그러면 이 금에 대한 집착이 저절로 없어져요.
Then once you realize that this is not gold, your attachment to this piece of rock disappears.
집착을 놓차 해가 나아지는 게 아니라 그만 아니네 하면 저절로 없어져 버려.
So attachment does not go away just because you try to de-attach yourself. It goes away by realizing that this is not worth your attachment to begin with.
자기는 지금 그 남자를 아직 금이라고 생각하고 있는 거예요.
You still think your ex-boyfriend is gold.
Yeah.
그게 금이 아니라 세부치인 줄 알아버리면 돼요.
So your way to de-attachment is realizing your ex-boyfriend is just a piece of worthless metal.
I feel like I realize it because, like, over the past month, so many people told me, and probably him himself. Like, I'm sure at one point he told me to, but it's just like I haven't come to that realization yet. I don't think I have since I'm still not over it.
네네, 그럼 좀 괴로워해야 돼.
Then you know, then you have to suffer.
네, 그 꿈속에서 좀 더 강도에게 쫓겨야 합니다.
Then you have to, you know, have keep your nightmare going a little more.
깨기가 지금 싫으니까.
Because you don't actually want to wake up.
이건 뭐하고 같았냐? 이게 지금 좋은 꿈이라서 그래요.
And that's because your nightmare is really not a nightmare yet. It's
자기가
a good
어떤
dream.
꿈속에서 왕자를 만났다.
Say you met a prince.
아주 재미있게 즐겼다.
And you had this good, great time with this prince in your dream.
근데 깨니까 꿈이다.
And you woke up and realized it was just a dream.
너무너무 아쉬워.
Then you know you want to go back.
그래서 베개를 잡고 다시 그 꿈을 생각해.
And you want to go back to sleep. You know you hug your pillows tighter.
그래서 이 좋은 꿈이
so, and this dream,
잠을 깨는데 방해였습니다.
You know, so good dreams are actually bad for you because you don't want to wake up from a good dream.
꿈을 깨기 전에는.
But before you wake up,
나쁜 꿈보다 좋은 꿈이 더 좋은 것 같지만.
You know, as you're dreaming, you think a good dream is actually good for you because it makes you feel good.
꿈을 깨고 나면.
But once you actually do wake up,
나쁜 꿈이 훨씬 더 좋아요.
You realize that nightmares are actually better for you.
그래서 모든 성인이 부처님이고 예수님이고 다 나쁜 꿈을 통해서 꿈에서 잠에서 완전히 깬 거예요.
So all the sages in this world and throughout history actually achieve their wakefulness from a nightmare.
그래서 예수님께서 고통 속에서 하나님의 음성이 들린다 이런 말을 했어.
That's why Jesus told us that he hears God's voice through his suffering.
자기는 아직 달콤한 꿈 속에서 좀 더 베개를 붙들고 꿈을 좀 더 꾸세요.
So you should, you know, hold your pillows a little tighter and continue to dream that good dream.
당신이 잘 때 우리는 저 멀리 가버릴 거예요.
Because as you dream, others will grow behind you and will leave you behind.
이렇게 이미 헤어졌어요?
So are you broken up?
Yeah.
아니 다시 노력하면 만날 수 있어요?
Or is it a possibility you guys can get back together again?
I don't know.
모르겠습니다. 아, 그럼 노력하세요.
Then go ahead. You know, try your best.
But I feel really pathetic in that way.
아니 자기 좋아하는 사람을 만나는데 거기 무슨 자존심을 세우고 그래요?
Yeah. Why this pride? You're trying to get back together with somebody you want to.
그건 사랑이 아니에요.
That's not love.
사랑에 무슨 자존심을 세우고 그래요?
You know, why does pride have to interfere with love?
가서 이렇게 말하세요.
So tell him.
내가 너하고 같이 있을 때는
when I was with you,
너가 좋은 줄 몰랐다.
I didn't realize how good you were.
너하고 떨어져 보니까
now that we've been apart,
너는 나한테 너무나 소중한 존재였다.
Now I realize how precious you are to me.
그래서 난 너에게 돌아왔다.
So that's why I want to come back.
저를 받아주세요.
So please accept me.
뭐든지 시킨 대로 하겠습니다.
If you take me back, I'll do whatever you want.
나는 당신의 종이 되겠습니다.
I'll be your servant.
나의 왕이 되어 주세요.
Please be my king.
이렇게 해서 잡아야 돼요.
Then you gotta grab him.
그럴 정도로 노력할 가치는 없다. 이거죠.
So you're saying that he's not worth all that.
그만큼 좋지는 않다.
So you don't like him that much.
Yeah.
지가 와서 나한테 무릎 꿇고 잘못했다면 받아줄 정도는 용의가 있다. 이거죠.
So you want him to come to you and beg for forgiveness and get back together on his knees. And that you might entertain.
네, 그럼 기다려 보세요.
Then okay, let's wait then.
그리고 다른 거 찾아보세요.
Then look for some other people.
더 좋은 게 나타나면 아마 잊어질 거예요.
And then if some other guy who's much better comes along, you'll probably forget him naturally.
헤어지는 건 나쁜 게 아니에요.
So breaking up in itself is not bad.
헤어질 때는 이렇게 기도해야 됩니다.
So this is how you should pray when you break up.
그동안 감사했어요. 당신을 만나서 행복했습니다.
So offer a prayer of gratitude and say, you know, I was happy the time I was with you.
감사합니다.
Thank you.
당신이 떠나줘서 감사합니다.
And thank you for leaving me.
그래야 더 좋은 사람을 만나니까.
So that I can meet a much better person.
Yeah. and well, I kind of want to be more independent instead of depending on other people. Like just not really with guys, but with like everyone, even friends, family. I just feel like I need to be more independent since I'm, you know, growing.
그러면 사람을 좀 많이 만나보세요.
Then meet more people.
자꾸 떠나줘야 많이 만날 수 있어.
And you know, let the guys leave and meet others.
지금부터 목표를 세우고.
So have a goal.
열 번째 사람이 내가 만날 사람이다.
Say that you know the tenth guy I date will be the guy.
사람이 지나갈 때마다 아 이건 지금 아직은 아니다.
And every time you date somebody, no matter how hard you fall for that guy, say this is not the guy.
그러면 편하게 만날 수 있습니다.
That would you know allow you to meet that person in more of a light-hearted way.
여기서 내가 버리는 것은 여기 해당이 되지 않습니다. 내가 싫다는 것.
So if you reject the guy. It doesn't apply here.
자기가 떠나는 것을 말합니다.
So I'm saying that if you get rejected.
그가 떠나주기 때문에 나는 진짜 열 번째 사람을 만날 수가 있는 거예요.
Since that person breaks up with you, that gives you an opportunity to get to that tenth guy.
근데 재수 없이 다섯 번째에 떠나지 않는 사람이 생길 수가 있습니다.
But of course, there's always the danger of the fifth guy not breaking up with you.
그럼 뭐 살아야 됩니다.
And that's unfortunate, but you gotta live with that guy.
그런 마음으로 만나면 아무런 부담이 없습니다.
And if you approach your relationship in this light-hearted way, then there's not so much that you're carrying on that.
즉, 당신은 사람에게 집착한다는 거예요.
You know, the thing is that you're attaching, you're obsessing over people.
제가 열 명을 얘기하는 것은 집착하지 말라는 얘기예요.
The reason I brought up the tenth guy is that don't overly obsessed over one individual.
지금 나에게 일어나는 일이 좋은지 나쁜지 지금 알 수가 없습니다.
The thing that are happening to you today, nobody can tell whether that actually will turn out to be bad or good.
한참 지나봐야 합니다.
That only becomes clear once a lot of time has passed.
그렇기 때문에 지금 일에 너무 이렇게 집착할 필요가 없다.
That's why you don't have to overly worry and obsess over what happened now.
만약에 헤어지게 된다면
And if you do end up breaking up,
더 좋은 일이 생기려고 이런 일이 생겼구나.
Tell yourself, well, this is all for all the best because something else better will happen to me.
지금 일어난 일을 긍정적으로 받아들여.
And accept what happened now in a positive light.
네.